The youth should also be aware of their rights as consumers. This is why the Department of Trade and Industry has developed education materials on consumer welfare protection, which are integrated into the high school curriculum. Now, here to tell us more about this is Mr. Victorio Di Magiba, Director of the DTI Bureau of Trade, Regulation and Consumer Protection. Good morning, sir. Thank you very much for joining us again here in the studio.
Hi, good morning, Ron.
Let's talk about your consumer education programs. What's in it? What's it all about?
Yeah, you know, starting this school year, Ron, all public high school students will be taught basics on consumer education. What does it mean? You know, there are 8 subjects in a high school right now. You know, math, science, English, Filipino, aralin panlipunan, values, physical education, music. No, in each of these subjects, Ron, we develop a lesson exemplar. It's a technical term used in teaching. And integrated all the consumer laws in the 8 different subjects. It's not a case of just, I want to teach you what is the Consumer Act. Not that kind of education. The Consumer Act was, you know, chopped into pieces and then then integrated in all of these 8 subjects.
You sort of got pieces of the Consumer Act and then
put it in 8. That's right.
Hinalo nyo sa math, hinalo nyo sa science, hinalo nyo sa ibang subjects.
That's right. Now, just in order that listeners and viewers can understand what we are talking about, you know, like this, you know, this is the lesson exemplar for aralin and panlipunan. Okay. What is the consumer education in aralin panlipunan? Now, if you open this, you know, there is a subject on the rights of senior citizens.
Okay, tama.
Karapatan ng mga matatanda. Okay. Meron din mga pananagutan na mamimili. That's aralin panlipunan. And then there is also the promotion of the one town, one product.
Right.
Yung sariling atin, you know, how you develop your own product in all your provinces. Ganun yung ginamang integration ng consumer education. So this school year, all first-year students, no, in pilot schools all over the Philippines, 180 lahat yan eh, at least 10 schools in each region, will be taught this lesson exemplars.
Ngayon lang nag-umpisa to? This school year lang mag-uumpisa to?
Yung pilot, yeah, this lang. This school year lang yan, Ron. Because, alam mo, ito lang produkto na to, itong product na to. 3 years in the making to. Yun mo yung pagsulat nito. These are done by teachers, superintendents, and principals. Kasi ito, pag nandyan na siya sa curriculum, magiging textbook na siya. Part na siya na textbook. Ngayon, lesson exemplar, ano ito eh, tulong sa pagtuturo ng teacher. Wala pa siya sa textbook talaga. Yan ay yung final output. Kapag textbook na siya, then anybody can read it. You know?
Okay, who conceptualized this? Who thought about chopping up the Consumer Act and then teaching it? It is a good idea. You get introduced to the Consumer Act, consumer welfare, and you know your products. You know what you're going to do with products that may be defective, and you know how things would work.
Well, ganito lang yon. You know, we thought that teaching consumer laws and everything should begin, you know, when we are still young. Ngayon kasi, what we are doing, we're talking about consumer hotline, but then this addressed to adults.
Right. You know?
But this one is addressed now to high school students. So, sabi namin, there is in the law, in the Consumer Act, that the Department of Education is the agency primarily responsible for teaching education, but we have to help them because, you know, we have DTI, we have DA and DOH, and all these are the implementing agencies. So, we thought about how do we integrate this body of consumer laws into the formal education. Hindi yung pira-piraso. Hindi mag-appear ka sa TV, interview mo sa radio, etc.
Meron usually before sa school, yung mga lalabas once a year.
Ito ngayon,
twice a year. Hindi maaalala ng mga bata.
Pag-graduate mo ng high school, alam mo na. Parang may math din dyan. You know, conversion of kilos to pounds. Ituturo yan sa correct weight ng timbangan. And measures yan.
Which is something you're gonna find out, have to know about eventually. Yeah.
Chemistry. Talk about battery. Ano yan? Pag-aaralan yan sa electrochemical energy. How do you transform chemical energy to electrical energy? Ganun ang pagturo. Yung technical aspect, isinama yung consumer education. Standards kasama na dyan.
Okay, you talked about pilot schools. It's going to be implemented this year. How many schools are we talking about? This is just for high school students.
This is just for high school,
right?
As of now.
How many pilot schools are we talking about?
180 public high schools beginning this school year.
Mga gaano kadaming estudyante?
180. Kada region.
60 per classroom ba pinag-uusapan natin?
Hindi ko alam ang high school, no? Ang 60 siguro sa elementary. Sa high school siguro, smaller. Kasi nababawasan yan si Golon, di ba? So, yun. But by 2015 school year, Ron, ano na to? In all public high school na to. 6,000 yan, ha? Public high school.
Yeah.
And then, wala namang masama. A private high school would like to teach them, you know, use this as reference material. Okay.
Alright.
Kasi nag-develop kami ng parang information kit, no? Ito parang bibliography ito. Everything that you see here, nandito ngayon. So, one book na ito. All the consumer laws, trade industry laws na ginamit namin dyan, nandito sa reference.
Okay. Itong consumer education information kit, yan yung Bible mo eh.
Yan yung Bible.
Tapos,
mo.
Tapos, meron tayong dalawang klase.
Yung mga lesson exemplars mo.
Yeah, we have teacher support materials. Ito yung mga bibigay sa mga
that's
teacher.
That's right.
Asan yung mga ibibigay sa mga estudyante na babasahin nila?
Well,
iba pa ba yun? This is a sample of a teacher support material.
Ang style run ng teaching dyan, by activity. Bibigyan sila activity, no? They will be broken down into groups and then pag-aaralan. So yung ganun, wala pa siyang bibigay material sa estudyante kasi wala pa naman to sa textbook eh. Teacher pa lang may hawak dito.
Okay, let's talk about the four modules for the students. Ang umpisa nyo, you're gonna be talking about four products here. You have automotive battery, CFL, flat glass, and LPG cylinder. Nakakatawa nga yung mga title ng mga modules na eh. Battery, magic ng baterya ang pangsasakyan.
Kasi liwanag sa dilim. Kailangan sa bata yan eh. Kasi kung high school ka, ay tuturo siya, automotive battery. Hindi pa naman siya pwede mag-drive.
Tsaka pag binigyan ka ng mga ganun pangalan, parang ano yun?
It catches you attention. Attention mo as a high school student. Apat lang yan ron, pero actually 10 na. No? Now we're also developing teaching modules for cement, ceramic tiles, electric iron, yung nagamit plant sa bahay, lighter, monoblock chair, plastic natin dyan, tsaka yung posporo, safety macho.
So for this year, paumpisa natin yan, tapos you're gonna have an assessment at the end of the school year to find out how effective the program
is. Even as we pilot it, may mga tao tayo umiikot observing. Observing both from DTI and DepEd and the regional level. No? Clarify ko lang, dito sa mga produkto na binasa ko na may standards, ginagamit din dito sa mga alternative learning center. Yung mga non-formal education, yung hindi formal, yung high school, formal yun, enroll ka. No? Meron tayong mga alternative learning centers sa mga barangayan na hindi naman sila nakakuha ng degree. Tinuturo din ito, kasama ito sa mga teaching materials nila.
Okay. Mr. Victorio Dimagiba, thank you very much for joining us this morning. I'm sorry you have to cut our interview short. Maraming salamat. Yeah.